Assalamualaikum my dear. Yes, I hope you are doing great. So before starting my new lesson, I would like to give a brief recap of the previous one. In our previous lesson, we have started the chapter number 5, Farming and Forest. This chapter, as you know, is related to plantation, agriculture and soil. And I told you that for the better agriculture, always a fertile soil is needed. And the best fertile soil is known as the alluvial soil. This kind of the soil you can find on the banks of the rivers, because when the river overflows and the flood happens, they deposit the good soil on the land. So you can do the best agriculture there. Some are the areas where the crops cannot be grown, just like the hilly areas or the snowy areas, or where there are the steep and the rocky areas. So there are the some things. Let's move to page number 38. Today's topic is agriculture. As you know that agriculture is the main profession of Pakistan, and most of the people are still associated with this profession. Punjab is a province of Pakistan which is the best land for the agriculture, because all the 5 rivers of Pakistan, including the Indus, Jhelum, Chenab, Satluj and Ravi, flows through the Punjab. Agriculture. In the Punjab and in the parts of the Sindh, there are large fertile areas and a good network of canals, so many crops can be grown here. In Punjab, you can not only find the rivers, but you can also find the canals too, that will also help in the better agriculture. Parts of Khyber Pakhtunkhwa also have good agricultural land, but there is very little agriculture in Balochistan. Why? Can you think why agriculture is a problem in Balochistan? Because Balochistan is not a plain area. In the mountainous area of north, farmers make field on the mountain slope. These are called terrace farming. If you have, you can see in the picture, this is a picture of the Sawar, where you can find the terrace farming, when the farmers grow the plants on the mountain slope. So this is known as terrace. Most of the agricultural land in the country is used to grow food crops such as wheat, rice, maize, millet, gram, masoor, mustard and groundnut. Farmers also grow cash crops such as cotton, sugarcane, sugar beet, tobacco. To make their crops grow well, farmers often use the fertilizer. So there are, as you can see, there are different kinds of crops to grow here: wheat, rice, maize, millet, and also the cash crops. Cash crops are basically those crops which sell to get the money. As well as the crops, there are large areas of fruit orchard across the country. Agar aap kabhi ye Rahim Yar Khan site par jaye, so you can find the mango orchards there. You can find the orange orchards in Sargodha site. Alhamdulillah, Pakistan is a blessed country where you can find everything from the crops to the fruits. Pakistan produces a variety of fruits such as mangoes, apples, and we also import the different kinds of the fruit from Pakistan. Just like the we import the best kind of the mangoes from Pakistan to all across the globe. Pakistan yahan bada mashhoor hai. Bananas, melons, oranges, peaches, apricot and plum. Although the Balochistan does not have large of areas of farmland, it does produce fruits like apples, peaches, almonds, cherry. Aisa nahi hai ki agar wahan agriculture nahi hoti, but you can also find some of the beautiful orchards of the apples, peaches, almonds, etc. Good quality fruit from Pakistan is also exported to the other countries. पूरी दुनिया में पाकिस्तानी आम का बड़ी पहचान है. Let's move to the page number 39. Let me fix my tripod first. Wait a minute, please. Yes. I'm sorry for the inconvenience. Vegetables are also grown on the smaller farm for daily use. You can help the country by growing some vegetables in your garden by not wasting food and by using water carefully so that none is wasted. What you can contribute for the Pakistan, you can contribute by growing various vegetables and the fruit in your garden. For example, you can plant a tree of the guava in your garden, pomegranate, apple, chilies, etc. I have my chilies and the guava plant at my home. A very important part of farming is livestock farming. What is a livestock? Livestock is basically the taken care of the hen, cows, buffaloes, etc. Farmers rear cows, oxen, buffaloes, sheep, camels and goats. Some are bred to provide us meat and milk. Obviously, what are the uses of the livestock? We can get meat, we can get milk. Others are used to pull ploughs and cart, turn water wheel. बहुत सारे ऐसे जैसे आप बैल के जरिए से बैल गाड़ी चला सकते हैं. It also help us to bring get the water from the well and for other work from the farm. Do you know that Pakistan is the fourth largest producer of milk in the world? It's amazing that our livestock is such an amazing that we are the fourth largest producer of milk. There are many international companies making dairy products which now operate in Pakistan. There is also a large number of poultry farms in the country which provide us with fresh eggs and chicken for meat. Obviously, we are getting the fresh milk, we are getting the eggs, etc. So these are very important. Forests. Pakistan does not have great forest resources. Pakistan mein itna zyada koi forest ka scope nahi hai. One reason is that much of the land is not fertile. The other reason is that the trees are cut down to be used as firewood or as timber. There are various reasons. Some of the trees are usually cut down to make the area industrial, to make the housing societies. Other some of the trees wood are also being used as a furniture, firewood, timber. Or even if trees are replanted, it takes a long time for them to grow. Zahir hai, jab trees cut jate hain, dobara plant kiye jate hain, obviously it's a time taking process for them to grow. When forests are cut down or reduced because of grazing animals, we also lose the wildlife that lives here. Cutting down the large area of the forest can also having an impact on the climate. And some of the grazing animals, just like those animals who are herbivores and those who eat the grass, is like the horse and the cows, etc. Wo bhi kha jate hain bahut sare trees, that causes the reducing in the forest. In some parts of the country, there are thick forests with trees of many kinds. In other parts, there are few trees. So, this is a variation. In the next page, there are the different types of the forest. We will read it out in the next lecture. I hope you have got all the concept regarding the agriculture, farming, livestock, etc. If you have any question regarding this, please feel free to ask after the lesson in the inbox. Thank you, everyone.